Hi, I'm Stan, the annuity man, sitting here with
Gary from Kennex.
We're going to talk about single premium immediate annuities, Gary, the granddaddy of them all, the original annuity. And really, most annuity types come from single premium immediate annuities. Little background for the people out there. Immediate annuities, and some people call them pension annuities because that's kind of what they are,
right,
started in the Roman times. Roman soldiers, dutiful service to the Roman Empire, and what the Roman government did is they provided a pension. The word annuity comes from annua, A-N-N-U-A, meaning payment. So right, that's where it comes from, and in the United States, this is really the only type of annuity that was sold until the 1950s. There's a lot of people that think that this still is the only type. So tell us a little bit about single premium immediate annuities and how they work. What is a single premium immediate annuity, as you call it, immediate income annuity?
Sure. Well, it's a way to purchase your own pension. And in this case, with a single premium immediate annuity, you're getting your income right away.
Okay.
After you make your purchase.
So okay,
you give the money to the insurance company and you know exactly what you'll be getting back.
It's a transfer of risk.
Absolutely.
Okay. So you're transferring the risk to the annuity company to pay you. Now, tell us about the payments. You can structure them how?
Oh, you can structure them in a way to even include a death benefit if you want. So you could essentially have payments go for a lifetime, mm-hmm, if you will.
So if I live to 150, they're going to pay me?
Sure.
Okay.
Absolutely. Or you can structure them so they only pay for a certain amount of time, say 20, 30 years.
Okay.
Or a combination of both. And the reason why you might want to do a combination of both, if you get hit by the proverbial bus.
Right.
Then your estate or your beneficiaries will get the remaining payments.
Got it. So if you did a life contingency and live forever, it's going to pay you forever. But if you did a life with a 20-year certain and your Learjet hits the mountain year one, your beneficiaries get how many more payments? 19 more years, right?
Absolutely. Yep.
Great. Now, tell us about the payments. Interest, principal, what is it? What's the combination?
Well, actually, what you get with an annuity is actually three types of return. You get your principal, your interest, and something called a mortality credit.
All right, give me the elevator speech of mortality because I got to bring you down here, bring
all
the
right
IQ down. Okay, go ahead.
It's your last man standing payment.
All right, give me more.
Okay, so you're in a pool of investors into this product, and essentially with life expectancy, let's say it's 85 years old.
Right.
85 years old life expectancy, that means you got a 50% chance of not meeting that age, or you have a 50% chance of beating that age.
Right.
What happens is as time goes on and some people start passing away, well, the money in that pool goes to the remaining participants of that pool.
Got it. All right. Well, that's pretty good. That's last man standing. Interesting.
Right.
Now, life expectancy is really the primary pricing mechanism, right?
That's correct.
Okay. So in essence, when you're buying an immediate annuity for lifetime payments, what you're saying to the insurance company is, you think I'm going to live to here, which is the actuarial, where you're going to die. I think I'm going to live longer than that. And if I do, you're on the hook to pay. Is that kind of what we're talking about here?
Absolutely.
So it's hard to calculate return on investment until you die, right?
That's correct.
There's no ROI until you die. Interesting. IRA, non-IRA?
Both.
Both. Increase inflation. Let's talk about inflation.
Sure.
Can you attach increases?
You can. You do payment adjustments. Majority that are purchased today just have a flat rate. But if you do put in a payment adjustment for inflation, just picture a seesaw. So if you're going to get $500 a month on a fixed basis, but if you want to put inflation on top of that as a protection, well, your payment's going to start somewhere in the neighborhood of $400.
Okay.
But it may end up at $600.
So at the time of contract, you can attach what's called a cost of living adjustment increase.
Sure.
Or CPIU, consumer price index increase. And it sounds really good in theory, right? I mean, because, your income's going to increase for the life of the policy,
right,
by that percentage. But insurance companies have the big buildings for a reason, right? I mean, they have,
sure,
the big logos on the plane for a reason. They don't give anything away. So if you bought the same immediate annuity, what you're saying is, here's the same immediate annuity with and without a COLA. Income starts visually here, right? So without a COLA, it's a little bit higher. With a COLA, it's lower.
That's correct.
To make up for that increase. So really, it's a bet. So if your grandmother lived to 99, and your lineage is good, and you're eating well, and you're not smoking 12 packs of cigarettes a day, hey, might put a COLA on there. Or you might buy a median annuity with a COLA and then one without a COLA, right?
Sure. You can buy multiple.
Okay. So where does it fit in a portfolio?
I think essentially you're going to want to build a floor. So you want to use it as a supplement to Social Security.
And maybe you're talking about an income floor.
Absolutely.
Okay, so tell me about this income floor.
Sure. Well, if in retirement, if you want to make sure you're covering the mortgage and the utilities and the food bills, and if your pension payment and even a Social Security check, can't cover all that amount, then what you may want to do is think about buying one of these products just to complete the guarantee for your lifetime.
So in essence, you could say, hey, you know, I have this lump sum and I want to find out what that payment is, how much we qualify for, me and the wife, whatever, on an immediate annuity payout. Or you might say, hey, I need $1,272.32 to fill in that monthly income gap, right?
That's right.
And you can reverse engineer it through CanEx to find out how much premium it takes to do that?
Yep.
Interesting. Benefits and limitations, because these are contracts, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, this isn't too good to be true. You know, we have to tell people the good and the bad. Let's talk about the good.
Sure. Well, essentially, it's probably the most efficient way to generate income. Mm-hmm. There's no additional options or bells and whistles. What you're paying for is what you get.
It's efficient.
Right.
Any age can buy it, right?
Pretty much, until probably up to about 90 years old.
At 90 years old, we have to, you know, tap that person on the shoulder and say, you don't need lifetime income. You've already beat the actuaries,
right? Smoke them if you got them.
Smoke them if you got them. Very nice. I'll remember that.
Okay.
All right, so that, what other benefits we're talking about there?
Well, again, we talked about transfer of risk so that you're not taking on that burden for longevity. And it's probably the most simplest and easiest to understand of all the annuities.
Limitations, there's always some. I'm thinking the biggest limitation is some liquidity. What are the liquidity options that you can add on at the time of contract?
Well, most of the contracts do provide a way for you to get out, but there's some rules attached.
I think the other limitation that I see and I have to explain to people is there's no market attachment. There's no like growth on the market growth or anything like that. And most immediate annuities that people buy are static payments, meaning that payment's just going to be the same every year. And people are like, well, Stan, but what about inflation? We've already explained if you attach a COLA or an increase to the policy, they're going to lower the payment. So there's a trade-off.
Sure. And I think for most part, people are going to address inflation through other means and other investments.
Interesting. Common misconceptions that I get all the time is, hey, when I die, the insurance keeps the money. I mean, so many people believe with an immediate annuity, you know, when my Learjet hits the mountain, I don't have a Learjet, but one day I will. When it hits the mountain, poof, money's gone, annuity company keeps it, that's a raw deal.
Right. No, I mean, again, most of the annuities purchased today provide some type of death benefit. So again, if you're going to get something with a period certain or a cash refund, and cash refund's the most common form purchased today.
And that means you die and whatever's left in the account goes to the list of beneficiaries.
Absolutely.
Policy. Okay. So interesting. Can you time these things with interest rates?
You could try, but
good luck, huh?
Right, exactly.
Interesting. Expensive. Stan, annuities are all expensive. I hate all annuities. All annuities are expensive. Does that apply for immediate annuities?
Well, any annuity or any product has some type of expense, but in this particular case, there's no explicit fees.
There's like no philanthropist at annuity companies?
No, there's no philanthropist.
How about at CanEx? There's philanthropists at CanEx, right?
No, we don't have any.
No, none of there. Okay. So there's none there. So they're not giving it away. So explain kind of the, in layman's terms, expenses when people say, what are the expenses on an immediate annuity? And I think this is important too. All annuity commissions are built into the product. What does that mean? That means you don't see it.
Right.
But that that very nice agent or advisor is getting compensated to sell the, you just don't see it. You put $100,000, you see $100,000, but
no, the way it works, like a bank CD. If you're getting bank CD and it's going to give you 2% on your money, the bank's really working on a return of about 2.25% or something to that effect.
Got it.
And so what they do is they keep the extra part of that return to cover their expenses.
And plus, they're holding on to your money. If you're getting a life payment, they're holding on to your money, then they're giving it back to you over time. So they're making a little bit money off that money off that money, right?
Right.
Interesting. The other one that I get a lot is, it's irrevocable, Stan. You rip the knob off the water faucet and the water comes. I can't do anything about it. That's not really true, right?
No, you have some options to, you can change, make some decisions, whether it's your payment, the payment you get.
Right.
Or again, if you want to get your money back to some degree. But there are some rules that you do have to follow in the contract. So it's not free and easy. But again, you change your mind, you can get it.
All right, let's look at some live CanEx quotes. You know, we've got the proverbial couple from Texas that's going to be our people that we quote. So let's look at what they're trying to do. And before we do that, remember CanEx and what you guys bring to the table is you quote the annuity world. I mean, you have agreements with most carriers out there. You quote the annuity world. And based on their specific situation, you're going to list the top contractual guarantees. So it's state specific because annuities are regulated in the state. So let's go through the quotes. What are we quoting
here? Sure. Well, let's look at Robert and Mary. Robert 65.
Okay.
Mary 62. You mentioned they're in Texas. But let's look at a single life quote. So we're just going to cover the lifetime of Robert.
So Robert really doesn't like Mary. He wants just income.
Exactly right.
Perfect.
He's driving the Learjet by himself.
There you go.
Okay. So let's say he puts $100,000 in. And as you can see in the results, a pretty good rate is about $500 a month for the rest of his life.
Period. There's no RI till you die because it's going to pay him if he lives forever.
Well, no, actually with this particular one, yes, they'll pay him for whatever, but we're also putting a cash refund.
Oh,
so
okay.
If the Learjet does get...
Yeah. Hit the mountain.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Mary will get the remaining amount that was not used.
All right. So he likes Mary. Let's do one where he likes Mary.
Okay.
And he wants to include her in the
Well, he could life. Like Mary in the previous one, too.
Well, exactly. He's great. So he wants joint life income.
Okay. If he wants joint life and he wants to bring Mary into the contract, that will be a joint life annuity.
Mm-hmm.
And so it will continue the payments, same payments. We'll assume that the same payment will continue even after one spouse were to pass away, if you will. In this case, if you're going to add two lives into the contract, your payment goes from... It looks like from 500 down to 435.
Okay, so that second life brings it down.
Right.
But let's say Robert's Ferrari hits the tree.
Right.
Mary goes to the funeral. Does she go to the bank and the payment's less, or is it the same?
Same amount.
All right, so Mary's happy.
Right.
What other quotes were running?
Well, let's go backwards. Let's say they're looking at an income floor. They say they're looking at their mortgage, they're looking at the food bill. Right, and they're looking at the Social Security check they're getting.
So they need to fill that gap. What's that gap?
Oh, let's say $1,500.
$1,500. Okay, let's run that.
Well, if you want to cover $1,500 for the rest of your life to fill that gap, well, that's going to run you about $340,000.
Okay, so you got to give the annuity company $340,000, and then you're going to get $1,500 a month, period.
Right.
Okay. And that was single life, joint life?
That would be a joint life.
That's joint life.
With a cash refund.
With a cash refund. So... The Bentley hits the tree, both of them die.
Right.
The beneficiaries gets what's left in the policy.
That's correct.
Correct, because it's a return of principal and interest and mortality credits, so it's drawing down on that asset the longer they live.
Right.
So, interesting. And, you know, people need to understand, too, the older you are, the higher the payments. Why? Because you have less life expectancy.
That's correct.
So it's really that simple. So let's recap immediate income annuities, also called single premium immediate annuities, and I've probably referred to it as SPIAs, which is what we call it. These are income now products. These are pensions. These were the original annuities. This is the granddaddy product. So if you need income right now, you probably need to be looking at a SPIA. CanEx can certainly help with that by providing the quotes, the best quotes in the country based on your specific situation. What would you like the people to know about SPIAs?
They're probably the most simplest product out there as mm-hmm. far as an annuity.
Mm-hmm.
And again, you buy it for your income now.
Mm-hmm.
You know exactly what you're going to get and get a chance to shop those carriers.
Well said. I'm Stan the Annuity Man.
I'm Gary from CanEx, and we'll see you next time.